Okay. Now, here is argon. You wanted to see some higher pressure ones where we get the spidery stuff. That's at 60 torr right there. This is argon. Notice we get bushing out as well. All right, let me open the cylinder and I'll take it up a little bit. There's 80 torr there. Notice now it's a lot more spidery. All right, now take it up to 100. Okay, that's 100 torr right there. Now we're really skinny. It's just barely breaking down at this voltage. It's taking a lot more voltage to break down. Change the color a little bit, raise the voltage way up. Get more of a, that's a 200 torr right there. Okay, I'm going to just bump the vacuum quick, just to... Okay, that's at 65 torr there. That's the mixture of helium and argon. Alright, let me go ahead and I'll add more helium to it. Okay, that's 100 torr with helium added into it. That's adding helium. We've got about 50 torr of argon and 50 torr of helium here. We get kind of a deeper purple. Alright, I'll pick it up to 150. 15, 120, 30, 40. Okay, there's 150. Okay, that's the mixture of helium and argon. Try helium at higher pressures and see what happens. Okay, I'm going to vacuum it down. Okay, look at that. Look how the argon and the helium have separated in the tube. Okay, the helium is gone, but that's the blue is the argon. It's interesting the way the helium separated out. Look at that, how we get a glow at the two ends. A Okay, we're down at below 100 microns. Okay, now I'm just going to open up helium only. See, 20, 25, 30, 40, and there's 50. That's pure helium at 50. Very, very low voltage breakdown. Breaks down very nicely. Okay, we'll raise it up more. That's 60, there's 70, there's 80, it's 90, there's 100 torr, there's 100 torr of pure helium. Notice we don't get any of the side brushing, the bushiness that we did with the argon. Let's keep taking it up, see what it does. $120, $130, $140. Okay, that's the end of it. I can barely get it to break down with this Tesla coil set at this power. See, if we run the pressure of the voltage up too much more, We'll run the danger of punching through the glass. Right now the voltage is set below the breakdown voltage of the glass, so we can't punch it through no matter what we do. But if I raise the voltage up past the punch through point of the glass, then just one slip and we punch a hole through it and it ruins the tube. So helium itself does not give too much of an interesting flow. Okay, I'm going to go ahead and hook the neon cylinder onto it. We'll try neon at higher pressures. Alright, now I'll go ahead and put some neon in it. That's 27 torr. Just getting kind of an overall glow. We get that orangey glow with the neon. All right. Going on up. 34, 50. There's 60 torr. Lights up very well. We don't have any problem with voltage yet. All right, we'll pull it up. That's 100 torr. Now we're starting to get just a blue. You know, the neon is not keeping the orange glow when we get the pressure up higher. Okay, we'll go up even higher. Okay, there's 200 torr of neon. Let me shut the light off. I forgot to shut the light off. Okay. This is at 200 torr of neon. That gives a very interesting glow. That's 200 torr there. Okay, I'll take it on up. We still are easily breaking it down. Neon has one of the lowest breakdown voltages. You know, argon and neon both have low breakdown voltage, so they are easy to keep going. All right, let's take it up to 250 and see what happens. Look at how that feathers. Looks almost like some kind of an animal feather. Look at that. Wow. That's at 257 torque. Okay. This has changed slightly because the camera battery went dead, and I had to change batteries in the camera, so I'm going to go ahead and open the cylinder again, and we'll raise it up and go on up some more. Okay, now I'm going to take it up to 300. Put it at 70, 80, 90. 300 torr. Okay, there's not a lot of difference between 250 and 300. We're definitely now taking more voltage to fire it. It now has to be within about an inch of the dome in order to fire. But that's still, you know, that's not a lot of voltage. It's only 80,000 volts on it. That's 300 torr. Okay, I'll take it up some more. Okay. 325, 30, 40, there's 350. Got lots of little feathers in it. You had feathers. That's 350 torque, 360 torque. The glass is getting very hot. It fires at a lower voltage when it's hot. Also, the glove gets real hot quick, too, because of the current. All right, let's take it up to 400. Okay, there's 400 torque. Getting a real snaky glow in there. Okay, that's 460. Not a lot of change now. All right, going up to 500. There's 500 torr. That's well over half an atmosphere in there. Glove gets hot real quick. There's a lot of current flowing through it. It's 511 torr right there. This is about the pressure that they have in those plasma spheres. They'll add some water vapor to it and neon at about this pressure, and that gets that. All right, let's take it up a little higher and see what happens. Five twenty, thirty, 545, 58, that's 600 torr. We're up getting up to about three-quarters of an atmosphere. Three-quarters of an atmosphere. I can barely get it to light. It's having to be right at the dome in order to light. A big snake inside there, big stringy snake. Well, that's about the limits of my gauge. Okay, I'm gonna go ahead and got shock. Okay, I'm gonna go ahead and bump the vacuum and take it back down. I think it looks better at around 300. Okay, there's 220 right there. 220. Look at that. So you still get the snake in there. The snaky discharge. But now you can get the feathers and stuff that you couldn't get at the higher pressure. Very easy to keep lit. It lights up about 3 inches away. The current is fairly low through it, so it's not tending to heat up too much. Still gets hot, the glove gets hot, but it's not as bad as it was when it was higher pressure. Okay, let me take it to 300. Okay, there's 300. You still get the feathers, and yet the string is a lot thinner. That's about the optimum, I'd say, for neatness. You get your feathers, and yet you still got that snaky string in there if you want to play with a snaky string. All right, that's going to do it for this experiment.